very interesting thing happened. A young lady from this area reached out and said, when I was about 8 years old, I was taken into the woods and shown these different stone places. And ever since then, I have been going out and looking at them. So I have in my computer a map that I have put together of more than 80 of these. Oh, okay. Can you use that? I'm sure we can. So we included her map of more than 80, and that's it for those of you who might know her, Eva Gibovic, who lives in Leverett. That was Eva. She offered that, and we utilized it as a part of the oral history that we presented to the National Register. And the National Register said to us, we went down to meet with them because I wanted to see these people who I knew were going to turn us down. They said, we've got this thing called the FAA, the Federal Aviation Administration, and they're in Washington, D.C., and this thing called the National Register, and they're in Washington, D.C., so these Washington, D.C. government types, I'm sure, are going to meet in some back room and decide our fate. Went down there, and the chief of determinations, when I asked him that question, pertinently asked him the question, are you all really going to screw us down here with this FAA? He said, the only thing I can guarantee you is a level playing field. We'll set up two panels. They will study what the state has to say, and they will study what you have to say. And they will make a determination as to which stories hold the greatest weight. On December 11, 2008, I get a fax, that's back in the good old days of faxes, from the National Register with a document, the determination of eligibility for the ceremonial hill, the prayer hill at Turner Falls Municipal Airport. And it started with the State Historic Preservation Office's declaration that what was there was not Indian. But the rest of the document was our professing that it was Indian and detailing how it was Indian, and the additions of the committee that he had put together. On that committee was one woman who had lived in the area for a number of years, so she knew local history, local lore, and all of that had been woven in to support the tribal position. And out of that, we had the first determination of eligibility for a ceremonial stone landscape east of the Mississippi River. So that's where we started. And, we give thanks to Eva Gibovic for having been taken into the woods when at age 8 and having been shown a lot of stuff that she didn't forget. And we give thanks to our elder medicine man for having the wisdom to quiet my fears and let me know that the landscape would in fact speak for itself if we would just allow it. And that's been happening ever since.